Hi, and welcome to the AYTM.com Piping Logic tutorial video. Today I'll teach you how to take advantage of a more advanced survey programming technique known as piping, without writing a single line of code. You'll learn how to use piping logic syntax and will become a mind-reading master of the survey experience. Piping is a way of referencing a question, answer, response, or an image that a respondent saw or selected earlier in the survey. It's handy for reminding survey takers what they selected, creating clarifying rounds of ranking, or asking follow-up questions about something they selected without a need to clone entire strings of questions. Our piping doesn't have UI controls, and you can add piping formulas directly into survey fields. Piping formulas won't count towards your character limits. Please note that in order to use this feature, you will have to turn it on for a fee at the survey level, or be on a paid subscription plan that covers it. Please also test your survey thoroughly and use piping at your own risk, since it is intended for experienced users. Just like conditional logic rules, an entire piping logic rule must be surrounded with square brackets. Piping logic formulas are not cap sensitive, although it may be useful to use caps consistently. Piping is expressed by pointing to the source that you want to reference within square brackets. I'll walk you through a few examples in a minute, but first, here are a few basic components. PQ stands for pre-qualification question, Q stands for question, SQ stands for sub-question, A for an answer, R for response, I for image, and C for a comment, otherwise known as an optional open-ended answer. Don't use spaces or other separators between the elements of your piping formulas. Let me show you how it works on a simple example that references a selected response. Say our third question is a single-choice question with two answer choices. On the next, or any later question, I can reference an answer picked by the respondent simply by typing Q3R in square brackets in the place where I want that answer to be referenced. Let's test it. Pretending to be a respondent, I pick the answer black, and sure enough, the platform remembered my selection on the next question and quoted it back to me, based on the rule we've just used. What would happen if I tried to pipe Q3 and Q3A1, or Q3A2? Well, instead of quoting what the respondent has picked, the platform would repeat the text of the corresponding question and answer fields. Here's how it would look for a respondent. Please note that the quotation marks are not added automatically. Surround your square brackets with them if you want the piped-in phrase to appear in quotes. You can also summon an image that was attached to a selection the respondent made by adding a letter I for image. For example, Q3RI in square brackets will return the dark chocolate image I saw when selecting the black answer choice. A good trick here is controlling the size of a piped-in image by uploading a placeholder image for it. For example, if I upload this image of headsets into the answer choices for Q5 and set them to appear stretched to the full width of the survey widget, the piped-in images of the chocolate will follow suit. While if I leave them in the normal attach style, the piped-in images will not be expanded. Let's continue with a more interesting example. Say I have four multiple choice answer options, white, black, red, and other, please specify. For the next question, I'll pipe in the selected answer by typing Q6R. We already know this one. What if, in addition, I want to reference the second response? By typing Q6R2, I will achieve exactly that. Note that the order in which the user selected the checkboxes is not recorded. We only use the order in which answers appear for each respondent from top to bottom. Please use caution when piping in multiple choice answers, because there might be nothing to pipe in unless you set minimum required and maximum allowed rules for the question you are piping in, as before. For example, if you reference Q6R2, but the respondent only selects one checkbox, piping will return an empty space. But if I set minimum required answers to 2 on the sixth question, my formula will be destined for success. Remember our other please specify optional comment? You can pipe it in here by using C after referencing an answer choice. It will only work if the respondent selected the fourth answer and typed something into the optional field. Otherwise, the platform will return an empty space. Piping can be used with open-ended answers. Let's ask a respondent to elaborate on the answer they just gave, Q8R. As you can see, my entire answer is quoted back to me here. You know Russian nesting dolls where there's a doll inside a doll inside a doll? It's a similar idea here. You can pipe a question field that already contains a piped-in verbatim. In this case, I'm piping in everything we just saw in an instructional question type, along with my enthusiastic answer. Let's take a look at matrix questions that contain sub-questions and answers repeated for each line. Here's a simple satisfaction-level question applied to the three sub-questions, white, black, and red. Silly, I know, you can imagine product or brand choices here, but let's stick with colors to keep things simple. If I want to reference the second sub-question, black, as it appeared for me in the editor, I simply add Q11 SQ2. Why would I want to pipe the sub-question text? Well, it's very useful in combination with piping their answer, which I can summon by typing Q11 SQ1R, like if I wanted to retrieve their level of satisfaction with the color white. Let's list here answers they gave to each of the sub-questions. As you can see, when you use R with slider answer choices, it'll return the actual words given in response to the questions. What if the answers were collected in stars or smileys? You would still use stars, but you'll receive a number of stars, or a type of emoticon quoted back. Here's how it looks for a respondent with a star rating. And with smileys. What's great about this system of reference is that it'll work even if the answer choices are randomized. Using piping with the reorder or ranking question type is a bit more sophisticated. Say I asked respondents to sort three colors in the order of their preference. I can reference the winner, the item that will end up on top for a given respondent, by typing Q17R1. R1, applied to the ranking question, will return the top choice. If you care about a particular item on the list, you can write sentences in reverse. For example, why did you put Q17A1 on the position number Q17A1R? Or if you're mostly interested in the winning item, why did you put Q17R1 in the first position? Or for the last item, why did you put Q17R3 in the last position? Note how I typed in the words first and last outside of the piping logic, but in the context of the R1 and R3. Obviously, to do so, you must be sure that each respondent sees exactly three choices, no more and no less, so be sure to avoid this technique when used along with masking or conditional logic. You can reference an answer given from a long list inside a combo box. Pick any number. Abracadabra, you picked Q19R, right? Or a whole string of answers from a cascade. Tell us about your vehicle. You can then either pipe in an entire string by using Q21R, or use answers separately. For example, to ask about their level of satisfaction with each of the levels from the cascade question type, make, model, year, and trim. Finally, you can do fun stuff by combining random skip logic and piping. Let's split our sample into three monadic groups by using random skip logic. Each respondent will see a large image of white, black, or red, and then will be forwarded to question 28 to continue. You can now tell which image a respondent just saw by referencing all possibilities. Only the one that was actually viewed by the respondent will be attached, or the first one of a few possibilities, if more than one. For your convenience, the system will update the numbers of questions, sub-questions, or answers in the piping formulas you already wrote if the order of such questions and sub-questions is changed. If you delete a source question, sub-questions, or an answer, the corresponding piping formula will not be deleted. In general, piping will use soft validation. If there are a few possibilities but only one spot, it'll pipe in the first option. If there is no information, it'll pipe in an empty space. Only if you are referencing something that doesn't exist in the survey or has no chance of becoming available during the survey-taking flow, then the platform will give you an error and will ask you to fix it before launching. Have fun! If it gets overwhelming, please simply reach out to us, and upon your approval of the cost, we'll be more than happy to take on the heavy lifting of your survey programming, allowing you to save time and meet your deadlines. That's it for now. Thanks again for watching, and feel free to ping us with questions or to set up a personal demo.